Welcome to Contact. We're in our third week of a series on restoration, and today's message is Something to Build On. And it's going to tell us the importance of this place in restoration of a solid foundation.
Right.
Right?
Right. And so Jesus talked about acting on his sayings. And this is actually, we were just talking about bodybuilding. You know, without protein, then you're not going to, your body's not going to be built up, even though you're exercising.
Right.
So what Jesus was saying is you need to hear my words and do them. And that's actually the building process. So if you're going to be, you know, restored, you have to feed your spirit with the word of God and then act on it.
Get those faith muscles building up.
That's right. You know, faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of
God.
Right.
That's like a direct application,
yeah.
You know, because I've been trying to build some muscle.
Yeah.
And so now I know I need to eat more protein.
Protein.
So if you're trying to build your faith muscles, you need
Without
to find
the
out.
Word, yeah.
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 You need to have a solid foundation.
Exactly. Inspiration is great, but you also need to have some meat.
Right. So I'm excited about hearing about this. Stick with us. We'll be right back.
Bring your friends and loved ones this Christmas season to Faith Landmarks Ministries for a Christmas play you won't forget. Celebrate the most spectacular birthday party ever held on Earth and renew your mind in what the real meaning of the season is all about. Join us for this special one-night event, December 15th at 7 p.m. at Faith Landmarks Ministries. For more information, you can visit our website at faithlandmarks.org, 8491 Chamberlain Road, Richmond, Virginia. Are you looking for a church that's active, engaged in outreach, and based on the biblical foundations of God's Word? If so, then Faith Landmarks Ministries is not only that, but much more. For over 35 years, Faith Landmarks Ministries has been teaching the Word of God, training up disciples, and expanding the kingdom. Through the fivefold vision God has given to Pastors Randy and Cherie, we make it our mission to fulfill the great commission that Jesus commanded in His Word. We invite you to come worship, receive, and fellowship with like-minded believers every Sunday morning at 8:30 and 10:30 a.m., Sunday evenings at 7 p.m., and Wednesdays at 7:30 p.m. Check out our website at faithlandmarks.org and view recent messages, see upcoming events, download study materials, and much more. You can also stay connected with us via any of our social media services. We invite you to come experience real, undoctrinated Christianity, where the Word of God is brought to life in you. We look forward to seeing you here at Faith Landmarks Ministries. Parents, if you're looking for a fun, safe place where your children will be taught the Word of God, then come on downtown to Kidstown, here at Faith Landmarks Ministries, 8491 Chamberlain Road, Richmond, Virginia.
Okay, Matthew chapter 16, verse 13, it says, when Jesus came to the coasts, that's just old English for the area, the neighborhood, Caesarea Philippi. If you've been to Israel, you've been to Caesarea Philippi. Okay, now what that was in Jesus' day was it was a resort area, very similar to hot springs here in our own state. Okay, which were, you know, places like that have been a resort area for a long time. Okay, so Jesus went to a resort with his disciples? Yeah. Hallelujah. And then he said, he said to them, who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? Whom do they say that I am? Now, notice how he called himself the Son of Man, emphasizing that he was born of Adam. Now, if you understand the redemptive plan, the sacrifice, Jesus's life as a sacrifice would not have been able to pay your life if he had been of another form, like the the Son of God by himself. No, he had to be in the body of a man in order for his sacrifice to account for our sin. Woo, the Lord is good. Are you out there today? So who do men say that I am? The people that are out there, you know, what are they saying about me on Facebook? So they said, well, some say that you're John the Baptist, so that's reincarnation, amen. Others, Elias, that one's also reincarnation because Elijah was gone. Jeremiah, he was long since gone, so all three of those were reincarnation statements. Amen. God is good. Go ahead and say amen. So that's what they were saying. This is the way the disciples reported it to Jesus. Okay, but then he said to them, but who do you say that I am? Jesus answered and said unto, Peter, look at verse 16. Simon Peter answered and said, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Now remember, Jesus started out the question calling himself the Son of Man. Now Peter is calling him the Son of God and the Christ. Christ means anointed one of God. Okay, so Peter came back with, well, this is who we believe that you are. So then Jesus said, verse 17, he answered and said unto him, blessed art thou, Simon Bar-Jonah, which simply means Simon, son of Jonah, because there were other Simons around. Blessed are you, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed it unto you, but my Father which is in heaven. Now, notice the word revealed. Okay, so I'm going to ask you a question. How many of you know Jesus as your Savior? Okay, well then somehow you got a revelation like Peter got that he's the Christ, the Son of the living God. How many of you realize you have a revelation? Okay, well this is one of the things that God uses in our lives to accomplish things. Okay, to move us forward. All right, so verse 18. I say unto you that you are Peter, capitalized name, but yet in the Greek it's a rock, a little rock. Upon this rock, that's actually a big rock in Greek, are you there? You're Peter, upon this rock I will build my... So he wasn't saying he was going to build his house on Peter. He said he was going to build his house on the rock of the revelation. Okay. Upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Now, let's just talk about that one for a minute. Gates is a defensive mechanism. You know, you get past the gate, you break in to the city. Okay, old ancient thinking. Come on, are you there? Gates of hell actually protect hell. Well, the gates of hell will not prevail against you who have this revelation, and upon this revelation, I'm going to build my church. So here we are. Okay, church is around 2,000 years old. The church of the Lord Jesus Christ has grown to be the most dominant force on earth. And, you know, it's like nobody's crowing about it, which fits with the spirit of the kingdom. Amen. But there's nothing bigger, nothing more powerful, nothing as long in duration as the church of the Lord Jesus Christ. You ought to go ahead and say amen. So the gates of hell have not prevailed against the church. Hallelujah. Now, that's another way of saying that the gates of hell cannot prevail against you. So let's back up a step and talk about Lazarus for a minute. See, when Lazarus was raised up, remember he was bound in the grave clothes. And so the reality of it, he's a type of us. So you and I got saved, But just like Lazarus, Jesus said, loose him and let him go. Loose him from all of the past and let him go. Okay, so the power to move forward in your life is based upon the revelation that you have. So let's say that you left some things behind. Okay? Maybe your financial life was in total devastation when you got saved. You now have the power, because of the revelation of the Lord Jesus Christ, to move into a new financial life. Okay, restoration. He's going to make it all new. Okay, now, like we pointed out, this being raised up can happen at other junctures in your life. For instance, some people, you know, we're kind of hanging back in the grave clothes with religious tradition. But then they got filled with the Holy Ghost, got a revelation from the Holy Ghost as to who Jesus actually is. Come on, are you there? Started moving out in the things of God, and now they look back and they go, wow, look at how my life has changed since I started moving forward in the Lord. This is what restoration is. Sometimes, again, the same believers leave portions of their life behind, like family life. So they grow in all these other areas, okay? Grow in areas of your life, but your family life never grew. So let's look at it like this. This is something that I believe everybody can relate to. You got a potted plant, and the light on one side causes it to grow and flourish. So people turn their plants. Are you there? How many of you know what I'm talking about? Okay, so you can turn the plant, which means the light is going to be on one side, and on the other side it looks dead. Or you can move the plant outside. Then the sun goes like this and the thing grows all over. How many of you are there? Okay, so that's actually the will of God for our restoration. It's not just one little thing. Some people just have it in one area because that's all they really want. Okay, now a little thing that will help you. The New Testament breaks down our lives into three categories. Okay? There's all the scripture on your church / worship life. Okay? There's all the scripture on your work life. Okay? And then there's all the scripture on your family life. So it's like three different locations. But sometimes people flourish in just one area of their life. For instance, sometimes believers only grow in their spiritual life, but their family life and their work life is left in tatters. Are you there? All right. Go with me, if you would, over to Matthew chapter 7. Okay. So what we're going to do is build a full life, but we're not going to build it on sand. You know, this makes for a bad foundation. Maybe that's what happened in a person's life. They thought everything was doing great until the storm hit. Then they went out and surveyed the storm damage. And sometimes, you know, houses fall down in certain places. The whole thing doesn't fall down. So the storm damage tells you where the weakness is. Okay? Now the thing to do is, you know, don't take it personally. Don't get your feelings all hurt and all that kind of thing. But just realize, okay, it's the will of God for me to have it together completely. If I've suffered a defeat, then He's going to get me out of it. Are you out there? And restoration is not necessarily building on what's in the past, but it's building on what His plan is for us in the future. So that, you know, it's called the abundant life, so that we have a full life. All right, so in Matthew chapter 7, Jesus described there's a choice that we need to make. Matthew chapter 7, verse 24, he says, "Therefore, whosoever hears these sayings of mine and does them, I will liken him unto a wise man." Now, I don't know about you, but I would rather be wise. Okay. Hears the word and does it. So then that means that person is going to hear the word and build with the word on the word. Okay? Hallelujah. So a wise man builds, and then verse 25, the rain descended, the flood came, the winds blew, beat upon the house, and it fell not because it was founded on the rock. Everyone that hears these sayings of mine and does them not shall be likened unto a foolish man, which when he had built, he built his house upon the sand. Winds came, floods blew, beat against the house, it fell. Are you there? The sand foundation gives way in the storm. Okay. So then the point being is that we get revelation. Okay, and then revelation comes in different areas. Now, God brings revelation to us not just to, like the Apostle Paul said, tickle our ears. He gives us revelation. We get a supernatural impartation of understanding from heaven about something that is His will for our lives, gives us the scriptural foundation for it, and then tells us how to act on it. The idea is, okay, I'm going to go ahead and do it the way He says. Now, we had family before the storm. The storm tore up some things in our lives. So we're going to make an assessment of the part that was built on the rock. And we're going to change the part that's not built on the rock, because it's telling the story of what got washed away. Are you out there? Amen. Now, I should tell you that family is one of the most difficult things for people to change. It's the thing that's actually closest to you. But remember how Jesus said to His disciples, "Who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am?" So Son of Man related Him to Nazareth, His family, His background, where He grew up. Woo, are you out there? The revelation that Peter got was, well, you're the Christ, the Son of the living God. So you came from Him. Now that completely separated. And then Jesus said, God showed you that. So the revelation showed Jesus for who He was, okay, and separated Him from who He was born of. Same thing with you. When you got saved, you're not just a Christian from Birmingham or wherever it was that you came from. I was born in Atlanta, Georgia, but don't hold that against me. I had nothing to do with it, just like you. But when I got saved, I don't beat the drum about Atlanta, Georgia. Who are you there? So what? You following that? So it's a choice that we make. All right, I'm going to choose the kingdom over where I came from. Now, you know, interestingly, people get really interested in their family tree. Okay, so years ago, there were some relatives on my father's side of the family who did a study of our family tree, and they came back with all this, oh, it was so great. You know, and it had to do with the King of Scotland and all this stuff. So I went over to England on one of our trips, and I went into the, it's called the Tower of London, and followed the genealogy of the ones that they said was our family. And when I got to the place where the guy was gay, I thought, okay, we've done enough. I'm going to stick with I'm born of him. Woo, are you out there? God is good. Go ahead and say amen. Just personal experience. But you get the point. Okay, so you could drag along this thing about your background, but it's not going to go into the restoration. So here's one of the things. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, the Apostle Paul divided it up, broke it down for us. He said there's wood, hay, and stubble that become the result of people's influence. Okay? Wood, hay, or stubble, or precious stones, silver, and gold. Now, what he said was the fire is going to destroy the wood, hay, and stubble. It's not going to heaven. It's not going to be added to the building that has a true foundation. So if that's what I spend my life on, build my life on wood, hay, and stubble, I'm working for nothing. I personally hate futility. I don't like engaging in things that don't work. It's me personally. Are you there? Okay, I believe I got that from God. Okay, so you people, you should not want to just waste your days away in futility working on things that are not eternal. So what you want is precious stones, silver, and gold, which, like the Apostle Paul talks about, that goes with your eternal inheritance, is added to the building, whose builder and maker is God, the true foundation. Come on, are you there? All right, so I'm going to hear the word, and the word, just by virtue of the way it works, the word is going to separate me. Welcome back. Really glad that you've been with us today on Contact. And yes, we are continuing our series on restoration. And today we're talking about something to build on. So when you're restored, when God does a big thing in your life, then the next thing is to start building everything back up again.
Right.
So Jesus talked about the difference between a sand foundation or a rock foundation. So that we're not just building on sand, which is going to fall apart.
Yeah.
And but the rock, and he's going to make it so that it is a suitable building.
Yeah, because storms come to every house.
That's
true.
Storms
come all the time. And then when the storm passes, you know, they always do storm damage, you know, inspections and see what's happened. So,
right.
But you know, Jesus told Peter when he said, "Who do you say that I am?" And he said, "Well, you're the Christ, the Son of God." And he said, "That revelation is yours, and no, the gates of hell cannot prevail against."
That's something to build on.
That's something to build on. And so when you know who Jesus is, what he means to you, what he's done for you, then, you know, things can come. Your life is like a building project. And so you want to make sure your foundation is sure. And that's what this is all about.
Yeah.
A sure foundation. Rest and being restored.
Right. So here at Contact, we're on the constantly on the doing part, which is we've been commissioned by the Lord Jesus Christ to carry the gospel of Jesus Christ to the world. So that's what we are busy about doing. We do it both here locally, like Jesus said, and overseas, worldwide. So in a few minutes, we're going to show you more about what we're doing specifically in that regard. But we want to remind you that you can become a part of the harvest. You can participate in all of this by sowing a seed online or by text.
You can find out everything that you need to know about what's going on here at Contact by going to contact.tv. Every seed that you sow into Contact is going to reach somebody with the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Now, at Contact and Faith Landmarks, we're constantly engaged in the Great Commission, and we have a mandate to reach the entire world with the gospel. We've just returned from our missions trip to Vietnam, and we'll have a look at how God was able to use your mission seed to produce a harvest on the other side of the world. Here's some of the exciting things we've been doing and a look at what's coming.
Contact with Randy and Cherie has been reaching our local community, our nation, and world abroad with the gospel. Since the beginning, it has been the heart of Pastors Randy and Cherie to see souls saved and lives changed through this broadcast. Because of your faithful support, Contact continues to grow and expand. We are reaching more people now than ever before. You can watch our broadcast on Fox Richmond, MyTV Richmond, MyTV Z Norfolk, ABC 7 Washington, and Fox 45 Baltimore. For air dates and showtimes, visit our website at contact.tv. Here, you can also view and stream our shows and partner with us from anywhere in the world. Would you like to become a partner with Contact? For your gift of any amount, you can become a partner today. Get monthly articles by pastor, receive free gifts, and get the latest info on what's around the corner. Together, we are fulfilling the Great Commission. Thank you for your faithful support and commitment to spreading the gospel here on Contact with Randy and Cherie.
Faith Landmarks Child Development Center is your choice when it comes to providing your children with a fun and safe atmosphere where they can grow, learn, and develop under the nurturing care of our highly qualified staff. Open to children from 6 months to 4 years, we are dedicated to having your children prosper under a loving Christian covering. Visit our website at faithlandmarks.org and enroll your child today.
Bring your friends and loved ones this Christmas season to Faith Landmarks Ministries for a Christmas play you won't forget. Celebrate the most spectacular birthday party ever held on Earth and renew your mind in what the real meaning of the season is all about. Join us for this special one-night event, December 15th at 7 p.m. at Faith Landmarks Ministries. For more information, you can visit our website at faithlandmarks.org, 8491 Chamberlain Road, Richmond, Virginia.
We'd like to thank you for joining us today, and we want to invite you back next week to learn more about restoration. Also, we want to remind you to join us for any of our weekly services or the special meetings we have here at Faith Landmarks. You're always welcome. May God richly bless each of you, and we'll see you next time on Contact.